When evening had come, Jesus said to the disciples, "Let us go across to the other side." And leaving the crowd behind, they took him with them in the boat, just as he was. Other boats were with him. A great windstorm arose, and the waves beat into the boat, so that the boat was already being swamped. But he was in the stern, asleep on the cushion. And they woke him up and said to him, "Teacher, do you not care that we are perishing?" He woke up and rebuked the wind. He said to the sea, "Peace, be still." And the wind ceased, and there was a dead calm. And he said to them, "Why are you afraid? Have you still no faith?" And they were filled with great awe and said to one another, "Who then is this that even the wind and the sea obey him?" This is the gospel of our Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
You may be seated. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. A number of years ago, a crew from a Japanese fishing trawler was rescued on the Sea of Japan. But when the authorities questioned the crew about what happened to make their boat sink, the crew on that trawler claimed that a cow had fallen from the sky. A cow had fallen from the sky, hit the boat dead center, shattered the hull, and caused the boat to sink in a matter of minutes. Well, of course, the powers that be could not accept that particular explanation. So what they do? They put the crew in jail, believing they've been operating the boat under, shall we say, illegal influence. Now, the crew remained in jail for several weeks until one day, someone from the Russian Air Force, led by the Soviet Union at the time, informed the Japanese authorities that the crew from one of its cargo planes had apparently stolen a cow and that it wandered on the edge of a Siberian airstrip. So it seems that these Russians had forced the cow into the plane's cargo bay. They figured with that cow they'd be supplied with beef for some time. But they ran into a problem. This was not a contented cow. After they took off, the cow began to thrash around the inside of the plane, placing the plane and the crew in mortal danger, which, of course, as we all know, would have been an utter catastrophe. So, in order to save the plane and themselves, at about 30,000 feet, the crew opened the cargo bay door, shoved the cow out as they were flying over the Sea of Japan, which I've always wondered if that was where Heloberger got their symbol, but anyway. But the moral of the story is, of course, as we all know, when you go out to sea, you never know exactly what to expect. I mean, that's what the disciples discovered when they took a nighttime trip across the Sea of Galilee. Now, of course, no cow fell on them that night, but that night, a pretty severe storm kicked up. You see, when the cool winds from the hills north of Galilee blow down and mixed with the warm air that comes in from the Mediterranean Sea, that combination of warm air and cool air has a way of setting off some pretty bad storms in a very short length of time. And that is exactly what happened that night that we heard about in our gospel today. The wind starts to blow. The waves began to splash the boat. And the disciples got the buckets out, but it just seemed that the water was coming into the boat faster than they were able to bail it out. And the disciples, they began to panic. I mean, after all, it was pitch black. And even though there were other boats that went out to sea with them at the time, no one else was able to see the trouble they were in. There was no Coast Guard to come out and rescue them. They didn't have life jackets. They were in a lot of trouble, and they knew it. So filled with fear, the disciples turned to Jesus. Where was he? Oh my goodness, here he is. He's asleep. Asleep in the back of the boat with the wind howling and the waves crashing and the thunder flashing and the boat kicking on water. They find Jesus asleep. Asleep in the back of the boat. And filled with terror, the disciples woke up Jesus and then used those exact same words that we have used so often when we are addressing God. Don't you care? Don't you care? God, don't you care that they laid me off and I have four kids to feed? God, don't you care that my body is filled with cancer? God, don't you care that all those people died at the hands of a psychotic gunman while they were in church worshiping you? God, don't you care? Then Jesus rebuked the waters and under the wind and used the words, "Peace, be still." The wind ceased. There was a dead calm in the water. Order had been restored. The 12 stood there with their mouths wide open and they said, "Who is this?" The wind and the sea obeyed him. Now, of course, we know the answer. Only God could work such a miracle. Only God could command the wind and the waves to cease. Only God can forgive sins. I mean, with their own eyes, the disciples had seen what Jesus had done. They should have known who Jesus was, but they still couldn't believe it. Jesus responds to their amazement with a piercing question. Why are you afraid? Why are you afraid? Have you still no faith? I mean, they had seen him heal the sick, cast out demons, restore a leper to health, make the lame man walk, and so much more with their own eyes. They saw, but they still could not believe it. They still were not able to trust their own eyes and their own hearts. They still did not have faith. They had everything they needed to survive the storm. They had a sturdy boat. They had the presence of Jesus. And yet, they were still afraid. Things were beyond their control. And they were afraid because they felt helpless. Isn't that true for us also? When there is nothing that we can do to help ourselves, that is when fear takes hold of our lives. When things are out of our control. And just like the disciples trembling in the storm-tossed boat, we also shaped with fear as we face the storms that threaten our lives. I mean, when those swift and sudden storms, they disrupt our peaceful watchers, what do? We pray to God for help. We pray to God for help, and then when God doesn't snap to attention at our demands, we wonder, where could God be? Don't you care that we are perishing? Alone, afraid, abandoned, we question how God can sleep in the midst of our troubles. And Jesus' challenge calls to chaos in our lives. He says to us again, peace, be still, have faith. There's an old saying that goes, sometimes the Lord calms the storm, and sometimes the Lord lets the storm rage and calms his children. We've been given everything we need to survive the storm, no matter how severe the storm or sudden the storm might be. God provides us with a sturdy boat, ourselves, and the community around us that we call the church. We are provided also with the presence of Christ, not out there somewhere, but here with us, in the boat, tossed by the waves and the wind. Oh, we want to be in charge of our lives. We think that if we take charge of our own lives, then we can survive anything that comes our way. And of course, that's no problem when the wind and the waves are calm. Boy, when those storms come up, remember to cling tightly to the promises of God's grace and the promise of God's mercy. Where is God when we need Him? Right here. Right here with each and every one of us, each and every step of the way. Have no fear, but believe. Who is this that even the wind and the sea obey Him? It is Jesus Christ. It is the Son of God, the Lord of all, in the midst of all chaos, the Savior for all of our dark and stormy nights. Amen.